This plant is on the endangered species list in Europe. So why is it classified as an invasive species here in Alberta? That's today's news. It's not hard to see the allure of this pretty pink plant. It was popular in many greenhouses up to 2010 when the province banned it after it was discovered the effect it has on shorelines.
It's a solid mat, so there is no other vegetation, and waterfowl cannot get in and nest, and fish cannot spawn underneath, and so it's quite devastating to the wildlife there.
Despite the invasive species listing, there are still some retail outlets which were recently selling it.
Yeah, so we had a recent case of a major retail store actually being proven to sell flowering rush, even though it's prohibited under two pieces of legislation. So we quickly did a response effort, sent employees down to confiscate the six plants that were reported to be being sold. So none were actually sold, but we did have to collaborate with the BC government to also get their stores emptied of the plants as well. So it was a good collaboration effort.
Public education plays an important role, and the province has an outreach program to inform lakeside residents about identifying flowering rush.
We can't be anywhere, everywhere in the province, so the public really is being leveraged to be an extra set of eyes and ears and know what's happening on the province. So they are actually finding more and more locations for us, and then we go in and help support the effort that needs to be done in controlling them and removing them.
And on that point, it is recommended that unless you have the proper skills, you should leave the removal of these plants to the experts.
Because, yeah, these things need to be handled quite carefully, because any little piece that breaks off has that capacity to start a new population downstream. So rather than minimizing or to try and minimize the spread, it needs to be under the guidance of environmental and park staff.